Welcome on NITV. In this video, I will try to make something new. Maybe you already know it, maybe not. With Marvelous Designer and Blender. So, we're gonna start with what character? Maybe Joy? Yes, where is she? Joy. So, let's start with this character. This is a surprise. So, I will keep. Open me two. Yes. So, Joy MD1, MD2, MD3. So, this one is MD4. I'm gonna make a simple underwear. Yes. So go to fabrics, change the color. Choose this one. And no polygon. We're gonna start with the up face of the clothes. So, I want something maybe like this. One here, one like this, like this, and like this. Okay. We'll click on it. Symmetric pattern with sewing. Ok. Select all. Here, all mesh on. Seems good. Select all again. Right click on it. Copy. Right click. Pass mirror. Align. It's aligned. Move it to the same location in 3D view and go behind, right click on it and flip horizontally. I'm gonna take the front face, move it just like this, okay. And now let's sewing, so simple sew here, from here, and here, from here, in front, here, from here, and back, here, front, here. And simulate. Okay, so we got a simple debarder. Stop simulate. Take the back face here, edit model. I'm gonna take this point and move it up like this. Simulate on. Okay, it's better. So we're gonna keep this. Sorry. Yes, I'm gonna keep this like that. Stop simulation. Now we're gonna make the bottom. So, polygon. We're gonna start with. We're gonna add a new layer. Okay, change the color, something green, like this. And we're gonna start from. This point to this point. So it's here. One point like this. Like this. I follow the body shape. Just like this. Using my control key to make a curve. I make something like this. A simple short. Zoom in. Click. Small control key to make a small curve and click and go back to the first point. Select the green part, go to remesh on, symmetric pattern with sewing, align, ok, select all, right click, copy, right click, past mirror, align. Move in the 3D view the back face back to the character, behind the character. Right click on it and flip horizontally. Okay, select the front face and move it near to the body. Like this. Okay. Now we're gonna add some detail on this one. I can move my back face more nearest to the body, like this. Okay, so what we're gonna do? We're gonna keep this shape and we're gonna make this U. So this one with this one, this one with this one. Now we're gonna take here for this U, this point to this point, and this point to this point. And the inner, just right here, so this point to this point, and this point to this point. Okay, run simulation. We got a simple shot. You can move it by hand, adjust the position. Seems pretty good. Now we're gonna add some detail. So stop simulation. We're gonna add some detail on the up and the down. So maybe. So let's go. We're going to use this one, Eternal Polygon Line. We're gonna start with the bottom. So the face front is right here. So we're gonna take this black point here. Click and we're gonna go maybe inside this point here. Double click for validate. Let's see what's happened. Seems good. I think seems good. We're gonna make the same here. So we're gonna start with this point right here and click somewhere here. Double click to validate. It is nice. Seems not bad. I'm looking. So this one and this one we're gonna make. This one here, this one here. Okay. We're gonna make another one just right here. And we're gonna go inside this somewhere here. Double click for validate. Okay. And another one. So it starts somewhere here. Maybe here. And we're gonna stop maybe more bigger just right here. Double click for validate. This one. No, Ctrl-Z, Ctrl-Z. Okay, we're gonna start here with the same point just right here. Like this, and we're gonna make maybe here to this point. Double click for validate. Yes, it seems better. So we're gonna make another point. Cut this one. Cut this one, cut this one, cut this one. And I need another one somewhere, maybe here. And double click to validate. Seems nice. Okay, we're gonna make the same from the back face. So we start from this point. And to this point, double click for validate. Okay. Now we're gonna make this corner right here to here. Double click for validate. Okay. And the same to the back. So So it starts from this point to this point, double click to validate, and the other one, this point somewhere right here. Seems good. Yes, double click to validate. Okay, we're gonna start cutting. So select the right here, edit model, and we're gonna take this line, right click on it, cut and sew. Okay, now we're gonna take those lines, just right here, right click on it, cut and sew. Okay, it seems to work. And now, here we're gonna, in transform model, we're gonna take this one, 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 and this one, right click on it and hide 3D patterns. And we got something like this. We can run a simulation. Oh, okay. Not good. So we need to make right here the sewing tool. Yes, from this point. We don't have sew to this point. So we need to use a free sew. So this point to this point with this one to this one. That's it. This one, this one, to this one, and this one. Okay, I think it's good. No, to the back, yeah, to the back face. This point, to this point, and this point, to this point. This one, and this one, to this one, and this one. It seems good. Run simulation. Okay, all this sew, we're gonna keep it. Yes. We're gonna keep this one. Stop simulation. Now we're gonna make the up. So for the up one, we're gonna make something like this, nice. Okay. So internal polygon line. And I'm gonna cut here, so I take click right here. I go somewhere here. Maybe a little, no, here. And now I make here. Double click to validate. Okay, seems good. Now I'm gonna start from this point to this one, double click. It seems good too. Okay, go back to the back face. So I align with this point. So this one from this one, double click. Okay. And now I align from this point. So this point from this one, double click. Not nice. Control Z. So I'm gonna start from this point right here. Yes. To this one. Double click. And yes, it seems better. Okay. And now we're gonna take this point from this point. Double click. I think it's better. So now we're gonna cut. So edit model, I'm gonna choose those line, those one, and those one. Right click, cut and sew. Okay, now we're gonna make a simple sew and we're gonna see what's going on here, okay. Okay, seems good for this one. This one is good. This one don't. This one is good, but not here. Okay. So for this you, I'm just gonna move those one like this. Okay. So free sew, and we're gonna sew first we need to know 68.9. Separate yellow 78. 9. Okay. Yes. That's it. 70.9 and 70.9. Perfect. Simple sew. This one with this one. And this one with this one. And I think it's good. Gonna run simulation. Okay. That seems good. Stop simulation. And now, in the 2D pattern, we're gonna hide this one, 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 and this one, and right click on it and hide 3D patterns. One simulation, and all is good. Stop simulation. Okay. This one seems a little too big. I will just modify here. So I select this, edit model, and I just take this point and move it like this. Run simulation. Seems better. Okay. Okay, we're gonna keep this. So stop simulation. And now in the 2D pattern, we're gonna just adjust the position of each part. So this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one, we're gonna move it to the right. So align. Okay, that's aligned. So I want space between the left and the right side of each part. So let's go. I just want a small space between both sides. So here, here, okay. Here is not okay. So this one and this one. Move it. Okay, and this one. Again. Again. Okay, down. Okay, this one is nice. Do the same for this one. Okay, seems good. I take my back face and move it more like this. And it seems good. Okay, so now we're gonna rename. Fabric 1 is just up. And Fabric 2 is bottom. That's it. Now we're gonna select the both layer and change the color to full white. You know why? We're gonna make a uniform color. So no. Keep full white. And now go back to simulation. Go back to UV editors. Right click on it. Set UV from pattern alignment. And right click fix UV to unify 01. And OK. Go back to simulation. You can save your project. So save as a project. And this is Joy MD4. Save. OK. And now I will just add a color quickly to identify them easily. So full pink, okay. And now what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna export this first version in first. So right click in the 3D view and hide all avatar. File, Export, FBX, and this is GMD4. Okay, save. So I don't have thickness, so I choose, I can add thickness if I want. You know why? I just add the thickness right before. So right click on it, show all avatar, select all 2D patterns, and here inside add thickness, I will add that 3. That's it. Seems all seems good. So now I got thickness on my clothes. So again, right click, hide all avatar, file. I can save, okay. And export FBX. So this is GMD4. Save. No thickness on. Okay, and save. No, right click on it on the 3D view and show all avatar. Now we're gonna run simulation. Like this, and we're gonna move the clothes as we want. So I want her nude breast. So I take this and I move it up like this. More like this. Yes, I want her breast nude. Okay, I stop simulation. Right click on it, hide all avatars, file, export, FBX. GMD4 up, save, fix, thickness on. Okay, now go back to file and open the project. We need to reopen the project the same. So this is GMD4. I just reopen it. Open, okay. It come back just before, okay. So don't every time you load something with hide part, it will reappear. So just select the part you don't want. So I don't want this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Here. Right click on it and hide three patterns, okay. Do the same for the bottom. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Here, 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 and here. Right click and hide three patterns. Okay, now we're gonna take the bottom, so run simulation. Okay, and oops, I forgot something. Stop simulation. So what is it? This one. This one. Hide 3D patterns. Okay. This one. Control Z. Okay, this one, right click on it and show the patterns. Yes, that's it. I forgot this one. So one simulation. And now we're gonna take this part a little bit like maybe this one more like this. Pull it down again. Maybe something like this, and the bottom face more like this, and here more like this. Okay, I'm gonna stay like this. Stop simulation. Right click on it, hide all avatar, file, and export FBX. This is a GMD for bottom and save, thickness on, and okay. Now we can close Marvelous Designer and we're gonna start with Blender. Okay, so Blender first, remove the cube, go to file, go to import FBX. Where is it? Right here. Choose the first one, GMD4, import, Okay, all is right here. I move my camera. Okay. Now go to file, go to import SVX GMD for up. Right here. Okay, and do the same again. File, import SVX GMD for bottom. Right here. Okay. Now in the selection scene, we're gonna take the up. Right here, we're gonna use the move tool, and we are just going to move it to the left. We do the same with the bottom, move it to the left, like this. Now, we are going to, this is not the good key. We're gonna select in the scene GMD4, the original clause, and we are going to go, where is it? Not here, not here, not here, not here. Maybe inside. Where is it? Here? No. Modificator? No. No, this is not here. No. No. Where is it? Here? Here? Not here. Yes, this is here, just right here, inside Object Data Properties. So we're gonna go inside Shape Key and add the Shape Key. Okay, this is the basic. You can rename it as Base, if you want, like this. And now, we are going to take this one. Yes, GMD up. Keep the shift key push and click on this one. GMD4 and add the shift key. Like this. I think this is this one. Shift key value. No, this is not this one. Wait. You can remove this one. So, base. Okay. This one. I think that's this one. Not this one. Okay. Ah! Where is it? Shiki. Edit mode, maybe. Yes, maybe go inside object. Edit mode. I think it's this one. No. Okay. Object mode. So I select this one. Ah, yes. That's it. Just right here. New shape from mix. Okay. So we move the both. So select this one first, shift key, and this one. And now, right here, add a shape from mix. Okay. Key one. Now it's not working. Again, sorry. I'm not a big user of Blender, so I take GMD4. I think that's here. Ah, yes, that's this one. So, add one. Okay, now select this one. GMD4 up. Shift key to the original one. And now, right here, join as shape. That's it. Now do the same. Select this one. GMD4 bottom. Shift key. And click on the original clause, this one, GMD4, and here, in the small arrow, join as shape. Okay, now click on the original one right here. As you can see, we got basics. This is the original shape. We got up, and we got down, bottom. So if I choose bottom, if I zoom in, and in value I made one, it moves. It transforms as the other one. If I take the bottom, value, It's moving too. Okay, so it's good. So now I just take my GMD4 in scene, go to file, go to export, choose FBX, and limit to selected object, like this. And I think all is good, maybe in geometry, apply modifiers, okay, it works. So choose creation. So this one is GMD4 blend and export FBX. That's it. And now we're going to try it inside the Caraterator 3. So let's open it. I'm sorry, I'm not a big user of Blender. I don't use Blender too much, so it's I don't make many videos with Blender. But I think this thing is very useful if you want to make a shape to your clothes or armor or item, if you want. So let's see what's happened directly. So I need the same character. Joy. Open. Let's see if it works. It should work. It should work. But we need to test it. Okay, so how to pose? We need the same pose as Marvelous Designer. So this is custom, this one. That's it. Now go to create, accessory. And we're gonna choose LMD4 blend. GMD4 blend. Open. Okay, so go to modify attributes. Pivot, oops, sorry, where is it? Modify attributes, pivot to the middle. And adjust the position. Okay. In front. Not too much like this. Maybe down. Okay. For in front again. It seems better. Okay, so I think it's good. And now we're gonna transform this one. If you want to see if it works, you just click on it and go to modify and here inside the morph. And as you can see, we got it. The bottom, it works. And the up. Hey! Woohoo! It works. Nice. And now go to modify attributes and transfer skin weight. And this can be used as default because we got one up and one down. And apply. Okay, close it, change the position of the character, like this one, yes, maybe this one, maybe this one, maybe this one, okay, seems nice, okay. And now I will just change the color, so go to modify, select the both, and I will make just a quick, like this one, maybe black, green. Oh, it's too light. Too light. Okay. And now we're gonna use the shape to test it. So go, so select the clothes and go just right here inside morph. And ooh, nice. The bottom, hey, it works. Yeah, it works. Change the position, original one. Yeah, that works. So this is blend shape. So you can use it. Let me show you how to use it inside iClone when it's done. So let's go to send character to iClone. And after, this is the end of the video. So first, let's Ça y est, ça. Content. I'll let you imagine all the different morphs you can do for your clothes. You can do any morph you want. If you want only two morphs, you can. If you want 10, 20 or 50 morphs, you can. Just use your imagination to do what you want. That's all. You can make a skirt up. A skirt to the left, to the right, and you can make a closet open, a closet close, all you want. So if you want to use it inside the iClone, you just have to select the clothes, and here, animation, morph animator, and you can use it directly to iClone, like this. And it works. Yes, it works. Change position, maybe. Acrobacy. Pose. Hop. Select the clothes, modify animation, morph animator, and tada! Magic! Yeah. It's magic. And now you can use the shape of the character as you wish. Tada! As you can see, it works. Hey! Sorry. I think I'm gonna use for this one. I cannot use this one as a miniature for the YouTubes. I'm gonna use this one, the original. Yes, I'm gonna take a screenshot and gonna use this one for the original. Okay, so thanks for watching and see you in another video. Bye bye.